application on these areas. They will in these areas. So even the faculty and students also can be trained to get awareness and ideas on innovation.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Madam?
Sir, please put the presentation. Hello. Then it will be easy, sir.
I'm not able to hear you.
Sir, PPT put in presentation mode, sir. Presentation mode. It is not just you open PPT file, sir. You have to manually move. Presentation mode you put, sir.
No, I am in presentation mode, madam, but it's not changing. That's why each time I'm just closing it and opening that particular slide.
Okay.
It was in presentation mode. Now it's in presentation mode. Right. Academic and non-academic incentives and the word mechanism should be given for the faculty. So academic incentives generally for all higher education institutions, but not for bringing in ideas and going for charter. Such academic incentives can be produced, and you can have a
clear. Your voice is also not clear. I think there must be some internet problem, speed problem. Please check it out.
Sir, your voice is not audible.
Oh. Yeah. Is it audible now?
Now it is audible, sir.
There is it audible now?
Yes, sir. Now audible, it is audible. Sir. Yes, sir. You can proceed.
So performance metrics for evaluation is a part of annual performance and contribution of faculty and staff. So they should, as a part of annual appraisal, these performance metrics should be considered for appraisal. So is it, slide has changed now?
No, sir.
No.
Now, A3 is visible. A3. Collaboration, co-creation, business.
No, sir. Slide number 8 is displayed, sir. Slide number 8 is displayed.
Slide number 8. What do we do now? So it is, I have put a slide on A3,
yes,
collaboration,
sir.
Co-creation and business relations.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
It is visible now.
Am I audible now?
Yes, sir.
No, yeah, audible and visible.
Audible, sir?
Yes, sir.
Yes, 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 yes.
Okay.
Please continue, sir.
No. Institute should have a policy for forming and managing the relationship with external stakeholders. And knowledge exchange is, as I mentioned earlier, it is very important. And collaboration with the other institutes and business establishment is important for innovation and startup. So knowledge development should be through knowledge platforms using ICT. And we can have an idea and innovation competitions, hackathon, workshops, boot camps, and seminars, conferences, exhibitions, And also you can have mentoring by academic and industry experts. And we can also give them life challenges. So these are the like platforms, ICT platforms has to be used to create awareness on innovation and startup, and also for knowledge development. Norms for faculty and students drive on innovation and startup. So this is the second rest areas. Norms for faculty and students drive on innovations and startup. In that, in incentivizing students for innovation and entrepreneurship. So some incentives or some consideration should be given for the students who are coming with innovative ideas and turning them into startups. Now allow all students, those who are interested to work on innovative ideas, to convert into startup. And they should be allowed to work part time. And this incubation center or facility should be open 24/7 at the institute. And you can allow them students to earn credits working on innovative prototypes, business models. So that being under the university, we don't have that option, but universities can do this. But maybe like in future, the UNVT will introduce and to award credits for the those who are working on innovative prototypes. But we can do say one thing, like those who are working on instead of working on mini projects, major projects, seminar and summer training, we can consider this working on innovation and startup. So instead of a student working on a mini project, major projects, seminar, summer training, we can consider this startup and the award marks for that. And you can give the students semester break or year break to work on their startup. So if they so desire to concentrate on that particular startup, so we can give them a semester break or year break. That should not affect their academics. And allowing the students to sit for the examination, even though they are having a shortage of attendance, this will be like an interesting feature for the students. But this will be with the certification of a committee. If the student has said yes, extensively on the startup during the semester, we can allow them to sit for the examination instead of having the shortage of attendance. And students may be allowed to use the address of the hostel when they go for registering their startup or incubation center. Through they can use the address of the hostel or incubation center when they register the startup. Next, incentivize faculty for innovation and entrepreneurship. Allowing faculty to start a startup. So college should allow the faculty to work on the startup. And even the faculty should be given semester or year or year break, either as a sabbatical, unpaid leave, casual leave, and leave, so that they can concentrate on the startup. And faculty are not restricted to restricted or limited to the number of shares that they can have in a startup. So they can invest any amount in a startup, but provided they manage with the academics, that is 20% of their office time, less than 20% of the office time only they should spend for the startup. So if because of a faculty has invested heavily on a startup, he cannot leave the academy and concentrate full time on the startup. So that is not allowed. As long as he is only 20% of his time is devoted for the startup, or 20% of his office time is devoted for the startup, he can be allowed to invest any amount in the startup. So that this 20% of his time, it will be like, even though faculty utilizes that time to go for a startup, that institute will be benefited, because from the institute they will have a startup, and that will give a lot of advantage for the institute. Institute stake on or equity on startup should be limited to 20% of the total share of the faculty or staff, or 9.5% of the total stake, whichever is minimum. So if on a startup which is total stake is 10 lakhs, and if a faculty has invested 5 lakhs on that, 20% of 5 lakhs, that is whatever faculty invest, 20% of that, that is 1 lakh. 1 lakh college is permitted, but there is one more condition: 9.5% of the total stake, whichever is minimum. So 9.5% of total stake means total stake is 10 lakhs. 9.5% of that is 95,000, and 20% of the faculty spend 5 lakhs. 20% of that is 1 lakh. So out of this 1 lakh and 95,000, the minimum is 95,000. So institute is allowed to put only this 95,000 in the that particular startup. So this is a condition imposed by MHRD. Now the norms for faculty startup. The role of the faculty while teaching, he can take the role as owner, founder, co-founder, director, promoter, advisor, mentor, or consultant. So these roles the faculty can take up in their startup, but he cannot be a CEO or take any managerial position and draw salary from their startup, as long as he is in the teaching roles. So he can have a share dividend, or he can take profit out of the investment, but not as a salary from the startup. So this is not allowed. And faculty should have a clear distinction between the ongoing research and the startup work. Okay, ongoing research at the institute, that should be a separate entity, and the startup work, that is different. So, and you cannot utilize the research assistant, that research assistant which you are having at the college to work on the startup. In case your startup is going for an national or international accelerator or incubation, the faculty may take sabbatical leave or other leave that is permitted. Incubation and re-incubation support facility creation and assess. So we can attach the nearest incubation unit. If a college doesn't have an incubation unit at the institute, you can attach the nearest incubation unit to the students to go for the startup. Now, the incubation unit at the institute should allow the students or faculty to go for licensing the IPR, intellectual property right, and to start up everything. The incubation unit should help. And then, so from licensing to IPR to start up everything, the incubation unit has to help them. And this incubation facility at the institute should be 24/7 to students and faculty. And mentoring support should be given in the form of pay incubation and in return of fees or equity sharing or solo payment basis. Now, regarding the IP ownership right and for technologies developed in CA, so if the higher education institution has put money substantially for developing innovative project, then IPR can be filed jointly with institute and inventor. So if the institute has spent a substantial amount in the development of a particular innovative project, then IPR should be jointly filed by the institute and the inventor. And if the inventor wants to start a startup, then it can be licensed to the inventor with a royalty not more than 4% of the sale price. So if it's a product, if it is sold for 100 rupees, and as a royalty, 4% will be given to the inventor. So that is a maximum, and usually it will be in the range of around 2%. Unless it is a software project, if it's a software project, it can be decided in consultation with the person who has developed the software. Because in a software project, the profit margin will be more, and you can give a larger dividend, larger royalty to the person who has developed this. Any dispute on IPR ownership and the revenue sharing should be decided by a committee, 5-member committee formed at the institute. So any such dispute will be decided by the committee, and it will be a 5-member committee formed at the institute. Now, some of the learning interventions are for entrepreneurship development. So the institute has to create and publish a toolkit. So toolkit which will help the students in design thinking, creativity, fundraising, financial management, new venture planning, product development, marketing, branding, and human resource management, and IPR filing, how the procedure for IPR filing, and the legal procedure for startup, how to register a startup, there are a lot of formalities. All these can be furnished in the toolkit. So, and also they should have a facility. So you can have a institute can create and publish a toolkit for students and faculty reference. And you should have a student club and bodies which you should be active, and they carry out a number of activities to promote the mission. Start recognizing and giving awards. Those who perform well, annually there should be an award given for the best innovative project, which will motivate the students to come with the better ideas. Teaching on tolerating failures. So our community or our city is not easily tolerate the failure. So we should teach the students, those who are going for this projects to start up, we should train them, or we should tell them and train them to tolerate the failures. And the failures should be discussed, and how the other majors of it, how they are required, all these should be taught them. So they should be able to take up the failure lightly, and they should anticipate failure once or twice before being successful as a startup. Now, you should also create awareness among students with the case studies of business people who has come with successful projects, or those who have failed. All these case studies should be taught to the students and created awareness among the students. And pedagogy changes, that is also important. So some changes in the teaching, this thing, so that our majority of students will work in innovative projects and they take the life challenges as innovative as the projects. So maximum students to have innovative. And institute. Yeah. Yeah, Daphne.
Sir, your voice was not audible.
And anyway, I'm done with it. Only one more slide is there.
So okay. Okay.
So is it clear now?
Yes, sir. Now it is clear.
Fine.
Sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Finally, there should be a performance appraisal. So every, say, like whatever we are doing, there should be a performance appraisal. Okay, so how the institute in a innovation cell is or innovation and startup is working. So because after investing so much in the and created the facility and motivating the students, what is the outcome? So we should have a development of key performance indicators, like in the form of how many IPRs are filed from the institute, how many students have come forward to work with the innovation and startup, how many patents have registered, and how many of them awarded, and how many of them are converted into startup. All these key performance indicators should be analyzed, and finally, impact of this, whatever we do, the impact should be assessed at the end of the year. So every year there should be a performance analysis. So this is what MHRD guidelines, and my duty was to only create the awareness. And sorry for some of the, like maybe due to internet issue or. Which I am actually in the morning I told Daphne I'll share the link, and because you know that will be comfortable for me, like I don't know what happened. Okay, anyway, thank you. If you have any inquiries, you can ask.
Thank you, sir. So thank you for giving us a wide knowledge on NISP and enlightening us about various norms of related to startup, sir. Thank you very much. Sir, Shanoy, sir? Sir, what of time, sir?
Yeah, sir, principal, sir, you want to share something?
No, please go ahead, professor. Please go ahead. Okay.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Please go ahead.
Yeah, please. Any HODs, Dean Madam? Anybody wants to share something?
Sir, no, sir. I have one question, sir. Manjunath Babu, sir.
Yeah.
Manjunath.
Yeah. Sir, regarding startups, sir, regarding the recognition of startups, sir, sir, for how long it will be valid, sir? If you are aware of
recognition of startup, so what do you mean by that?
So for how many periods, sir? That means sir, we need to renew it, right, sir? I'm asking about renewal. Once we start up,
maybe like I'm not aware of that.
Okay.
Yeah. Period will be there like 6 months, 1 year or so. But later on, after taking registering it as a startup, there may be like a tax assumptions and all other things will be there. I'm not very sure about other legal implications.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Yeah, Dr. Manjunath, I think in the last previous session with Ashok Patil, he has given a lot of information about this. And when our team visited SVC, the principal there was saying something like they have a lot of startups, they are thinking a lot of startups, and the institution is helping the students for around 11 months. Institution is giving them a place and helping them for 11 months without any rent, and they can do the startup. And after 11 months of the agreement, then if they want to continue, then they have to pay the rent to the college. And then if they have a complete startup done, then they can move from the college and they can do their startup on their own anywhere, wherever they want. Or they can also, once the startup idea is done, they can also sell to somebody else. They can sell it to somebody else. So this is the information what we have got. Even definitely we will try to get some more information about this. We will share about all this information later. Yeah. Thank you very much, PDS sir. So you have given in-depth knowledge about awareness.
Thank you, sir.
About the NISP. Yes, tell me, sir.
Actually, Daphne was trying for an external person who can give a better idea about this, because she could not find a person in the right time. I thought I'll just, because I have gone through it, I'm not an expert or anything like that.
No, I just presented. Yeah, this is actually the initiative of what even last, I think this 2 days back, even Dean Madam also had sent a message to everyone. Principal sir was also keenly interested in this, that instead of calling always outsiders, why don't we speak? Because we should not underestimate ourselves, that we are not on par with others. We are also good. Only thing is, little bit of more fine tuning has to be done by everybody, that we are also experts in every field. So let us also come forward and give some talks like this. So this is the initiative what you have started, sir. And henceforth, almost every HOD I request to give such talk, and even whatever the topic, whatever they are good at, they can please give and share certain knowledge during this pandemic period. And having said this, I thank once again Dr. P.T. Sudarshan for taking this challenge and giving a nice insight of NISP and whatever he has understood. It is not that NISP is not understood by everybody. It is a new term as such. Even everybody, they have to understand and they have to look into this. But whatever it is, if we incorporate or inculcate all these things, whatever he has told, so definitely it will give a nice ecosystem in our institution, wherein all the students and the staff members can come forward and at least convert their ideas into a startup. If not a great startup, at least they can attempt to convert that into a startup. So I request all the HODs and all the staff members and everybody to at least to come forward and take up as a challenge and convert your ideas into a model or a startup. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Daphne. Thank you very much, everybody, all the HODs present here. So thank you very much once again, PDS, Principal sir, Dean Madam, and all HODs. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you
very much, sir. So I request the participants to fill the feedback form, especially the students. I request the students to fill the feedback forms which have sent in the chat box, because it may not be circulated in the groups. So I request especially the students to fill the feedback forms. By the end of the day, you will get the e-certificate. Thank you. Thank you everyone for participating in the webinar.
Dhruv, come this side.
Madam, anything? Dean Madam?
No, sir.
Yeah. Okay, fine. Okay, shall we leave the session?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Students, after filling the feedback,